Okay, so Dan and Lucky, where are you guys? You guys have been dancing out in California for a while. Tell us what's like the craziest thing that has happened to you guys at these shows that you're doing for the ladies.
That you can legally say.
That you can legally say.
I'll leave that to Lucky here.
Well, it's two different ball games. We got, you know, we're doing club shows where there's rules and you're a little restricted, so we can't get too crazy in the clubs. And then we do house parties. It's a little more risque. You kind of set up your own rules and you can get bare ass naked.
So now, are either one of you guys involved with like in a relationship with a woman right now?
No, okay. Not myself.
Not just one, no.
Not just one? So pretty much that allows you to do anything you really want to do. You don't have to worry about, you know, doing something that's
right.
Not answering anybody or coming home late.
So, Dan, the man with the million stories, you were telling me about something that happened at a club recently. Why don't you tell me about it?
You sure you want me to go in detail about this?
Sure. I love detail.
Would you rather I left the room?
No. No, we have some fun times at clubs, especially afterwards. Afterwards, there's not too many rules that involve us, I'd say, after the show, huh? Yeah. After the show, it's all fun and games. So, after the show, we can pretty much do whatever we want. We take pictures after the show, we get personal with the girls, we get to meet them all. So that's when the person-to-person relationship starts with all the women.
Now, do a lot of women come up to you after the show wanting to go out later and go clubbing or looking for dates, or are they kind of just leave you alone? Or?
Some do, some don't. Usually our shows end pretty late, so usually we'd stay at the club and just hang out there. If anything, maybe dance there. But,
how often do you get offered money for sex?
Not often.
Really?
Not as much as you would think.
I wouldn't pay Danny.
Once in a while.
Otherwise, I'd be driving a nicer car.
My mother would. My mother loves Danny.
So the women, I guess, you know, come up to you and ask you to go out clubbing with them. A lot of girls forward. I mean, they just right to the punch going, hey, I want to fuck. Or do they beat around the bush like most women?
I'd say we get a little bit of both. Yeah. I'd say more women beat around the bush.
They don't want to come out and say that. They don't want to act like whores.
Yeah, the all famous one is what? I'm not like that. I'm not that way.
I've never done this before.
It's my first time.
Or they'll ask us, why them? Say, why me? Why do you meet me? That's one.
That's right.
So why do you pick them?
You're the hottest one in the bunch, baby.
I pick the ones and get that little feel for them. So.
Yeah. So when you, other than dancing, so you're out, you know, just doing your errands and stuff, and you meet a chick, and she asks you what you do, and you tell them you dance or you're a dancer, what's their reaction?
Oh, we don't say that.
You don't say that?
No.
What do you say?
I'm a real estate tycoon and he's a millionaire. That's about it. No. I don't know.
I
try to stay away from the dance thing, to tell you the truth.
Right. Is there like a stigma? Like if you say that to a girl, the girl goes, oh.
Yeah, it's either you get either a good response or a bad response. So sometimes they don't dig it. Other times, they dig it. But I try to stay away from it. I don't know about you.
Yeah, well, I'll tell them. Okay. See how they react to it.
What's your parents know, you know, you guys are dancers? What do they think about it?
Yeah, my parents do. I did a show a couple of years ago, I guess, with Tour of Chippendales. Did a show up in a town close to my hometown, which is Toronto, Canada. We did it in Kitchener, Ontario. And friends, family, the whole bunch came out to see the show. So it was great. They know what I do.
Cool. And what's your mom think? You've seen her little boy.
Mom liked it. Mom liked the Chippendale show.
What's up,
Hey, what's up?
But Mom liked the Chippendale show. It's pretty much a Broadway musical showing skin. So there was pretty much no nudity whatsoever. So
it's like Cats with
she
songs.
She dug that.
And I forgot your name, dude.
J.J. Ryder.
J.J. Ryder, future porn star.
Perfect porn star.
So how long have you been dancing with these guys?
About a year and a half.
Yeah? And what do you think of the experience? Because Dan's been dancing for a long time with a lot of stuff with groups.
He's another gold again.
Is he a jerk like everybody says?
No, he's cool. He's cool. He's too cool.
There we go. He hasn't got paid yet.
How long have you been dancing, JJ?
Let's see. About almost a year and a half.
Where are you originally from?
I'm from Huntington Beach.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Beachport. So, what do you guys, I mean, how long do you think this gig's going to last for you guys? I mean, you guys have any other plans? other than?
I mean, for myself, I know Lucky has a daytime job.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm doing a little bit of modeling, a little bit of video, just whatever pays the bills, but I'm getting into real estate.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll pretty much dance as long as I can. As long as the appeal's there, as long as it's fun for me, I'll keep dancing. And then just eventually, slowly, gradually get out of it.
Right. What about you, Lucky?
Same here, yeah. It's just, it's too easy to have money, so you might as well keep doing it. And the attention, you know, we all love the attention too. And it's easy, you know, easy way to meet women. So you might as well keep doing it. And then, you know, if you quit now and a few years from now and you can't do it, you're going to be like, God, I wish I would have done it for a couple more years, made a little more money, and had some more fun with it.
Yeah, better to go out on top, you know.
But yeah, you can't stay too long. If you're getting old, you can't.
It's a once in a lifetime thing. And the window of time is real short, so do it while you can, enjoy it, and get on with your life.
Now, what did you guys do before for work? Like construction, office jobs, what, sales?
I came right out of university in Toronto.
A university for stripping?
Exactly, might as well have been. It was psychology it started off, and then it was something else, and then it was, yeah, I was dancing at night, going to school during the day.
So you were paying for your school with whatever you were making?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And I just did that for a couple of years, and then I got right into the dancing thing, and then kind of the dancing thing took over.
So did you get your degree?
No.
You're going to go back to school and get your degree?
No. I'm going into real estate now. I did 2 years, and it was a 4-year degree, so I got my 2 years, and then I started dancing, and now I'm going to go get my real estate license and stuff like that, so.
You know, I could see you doing an infomercial on how to be a stripper in 3 days or less.
I could totally see that. I got it down.
And if you order my course, I'll throw in for free how to buy a house with no money down.
That's right.
What about you, JJ? What were you doing before?
Actually, I graduated. I'm doing my grad work right now. And got another year left, and I have my master's degree.
What's your major?
Physical therapy and kinesiology.
Oh, cool. So you're hoping to get a job at an all-girl Catholic school?
Yeah, there you go. Okay. Rehabilitating the little volleyball players.
What about you, Lucky?
I just did some grocery business. I was in grocery business. Worked at a few supermarkets.
Yeah.
About 5 years. But it's a grind. So I got out of that and got into this.
Have you ever had, like, meet somebody at your other job that may have, like, seen you at a show?
Yeah, once in a while. Actually, just on the street.
Oh, really?
If I always bump into people that send me to a house party for them.
And what do they usually say? Are they kind of coy about it?
There's the stripper! Yeah, there's the stripper!
Do you dance? Are you a stripper? And they'll say, oh, yeah, you did a show for us like 2 or 3 years ago, or whatever.
You ever have anybody come up to you that you may have been with for a one-night stand and go,
you never called me. What happened?
No, I usually call him the next day. I do usually call him the next day, no matter what. And then
Lucky
then
keeps up his public relations.
Yeah, keep that going.
PR.
Big PR firm.
Yes. Yeah.
Never know when you're gonna bump into him. So keep it cool with him, and you always keep that window open for next time.
You know, a lot of guys growing up, I mean, you know, there's guys out there that are probably, you know, 18 or 19, and they think it's like this great, big, fucking awesome life to be a stripper and stuff. What advice would you give to a guy who wants to be a stripper, you know? I mean, what advice as far as approaching it as a business, or what should they do as far as working out? In fact, yeah, let's talk about that. First of all, how often, I mean, you guys obviously have great physique, so how much time do you spend in the gym maintaining your physique?
I'm roughly in there 4 or 5 times a week.
Four or five days.
And about what, hour and a half?
Hour and a half.
Yeah, for me about an hour.
And any special diet or supplements you
guys? Yeah, we watch what we eat.
I don't. Yeah, everything in sight. I can't get into that kind of shit, man.
So, well, when you guys are dancing, obviously it speeds up your metabolism, so you can kind of cheat a little bit.
Yeah, you can cheat a little bit.
So, what supplements, I mean, what do you think of creatine? I mean, you think creatine is something that, you know, a guy wants to get into the gym, start working out, and get a good physique so he can be a dancer. I mean, what supplements and what kind of workout would you suggest to these guys?
Best supplements, I'd say, would be good food. You know, you stick with a lot of protein, a low carbohydrate diet, and keep hitting the weights, and you really can't lose. Of course, vitamins, of course, are good for you. Mm-hmm. Extra protein powder is good for you. Creatine, you might like it, you might not. I don't like it myself.
Right.
But I know I'll speak for all the guys. I'll do pretty much all the supplements we can.
Yeah, protein bars.
Amino acids, protein, good food.
Mm-hmm.
Is the key. The diet's half the battle.
You guys do a lot of cardio? Other than the dancing?
It's the dancing.
Just really?
Dancing. Sex.
What about like supersetting? I mean, you know, because you can basically, you're doing your strength training and you've got your heart rate up.
I do that sometimes.
Yeah,
I
mix it up with that too.
Yeah. You won't get too much size off that, mind you, but
right.
Mix it up with your daily routine. It's good.
So is it better for a guy to be big or to be leaner? Keep his normal frame and just work on
it. I'd say it just has to do with the symmetry of his body. You know, as long as everything fits proportionately and looks well-rounded and where it's supposed to look well-rounded.
Mm-hmm.
It's all good. You can be short, tall. You know, you don't have to be a big guy. We're not really all big guys, but
yeah,
we have pleasant-looking physiques.
Okay. So we have Joe Blow. He's been working out for 6 months. He's, you know, looks good and stuff. Now he wants to be a stripper. What should he do?
Hit the tanning salon.
Okay. So he comes back tanned.
Just back tanned.
Now should he go look for a group that's like got a regular gig in the city and go audition for him?
Best thing for him to do, I'd say, would be go out and get into one of the clubs that's having a ladies' night and mm-hmm. watch. And you know what I mean? Watch exactly what the dancer's doing and think, is that for me, is that what I can see myself doing? Because sometimes it's not as easy as you really think. And if they really think that they can do it, they have the beat to put a dance, a little choreographed dance together, and then of course think of a costume and a theme to go along with it. And after you get that done, pretty much just need some pictures to submit to different groups or private party companies,
mm-hmm.
and you'll be on your way.
How often do you guys practice your choreography for your the songs that you guys all dance to?
Probably like every other week.
Every other week?
Get together every other week for a couple hours. Kind of work through our opening routines, our closing routines, then the backup for each guy, because each, you know, who's ever acted this has a couple of backup dancers, so we need to, you know, we walk through that.
Right.
So a couple hours every other week, kind of just to keep it sharp.
Now, I've seen guys go out there and just dance their ass off, and when I mean dancing, like they're doing like Michael Jackson, Janet Jackson shit, and how do you think the women respond to a guy that goes out there trying to act like he's in a dance video as opposed to slowing it down and, you know, being sexy for the ladies, I guess?
I've seen both work well.
Yeah.
I've seen guys that go out there and really jam and the women love it. It sets off a lot of energy in the club. I've seen other guys go out there and just move around real slow and it works for them too.
Right.
So even a combination of the both, a little bit of hip hop, a little bit of dance, and then slowing it down with a slow song and maybe a little lip syncing. Always works good.
Yeah.
All right, cool. What was I going to say? Oh, so people like come up to you and ask you to like do adult movies because you guys are strippers and they want to get somebody, you know, a good looking guy doing the movies and stuff like that. Does that happen?
Sometimes. Yeah, it's happened a couple times.
Adult movies.
Would you guys do porn?
I would not.
I got a check for $500. You gotta go fuck this blonde over here on the bed. It's tax free money. Would you do it? And I'll get you more work.
Honestly, Lucky.
Yeah, when you put it like that, it sounds pretty tempting, but still, I'm not.
Camera on or camera off? Camera on.
Camera on, yeah. Okay, so obviously that wouldn't be like a thing you jump into right away.
Right. You get a little camera shy sometimes.
What about like doing, doing action movies? I mean,
sure.
The guys, or should I say, do people come up to you and go, yeah, we're doing an action movie, why don't we play a bad guy?
I wish.
Okay. Yeah,
that'd be great. I think we're still all waiting.
Yeah.
Right? Seems like Leonardo and Keanu and a bunch of those guys beat us to it.
Directors come to our show.
Exactly. Fun,
yeah, sure would.
All right, now here's your opportunity to tell the ladies what exactly they should do at these shows that you guys perform at. Now, first of all, tipping. Women,
they better bring money.
What would you say to the women as far as bringing money into a show?
I'd say it's a way for them to get involved. It's all about having fun. No matter what you do, you're going to spend a little bit of money. You know what I mean? You don't spend a lot of money, but you know what I mean? A couple of dollars here, a couple of dollars there. You know, each dancer. And it gets you involved in the show. And that's part of the fun and the games of the whole night. So it helps, makes it fun. And unless you don't want to be involved whatsoever, then sit in the back and hold your wallet tight, but otherwise, just have some fun with it.
Yeah, it creates for a better show, because it's a motivating factor when you're there to work. And you're there to make money.
Yeah, it's a tipping business.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I know a lot of guys complain, or like, it's like, the girl wants you to, like, dance for like 3 minutes and then she gives you a dollar. I mean, that, come on, obviously that kind of pisses you off. Yeah. So we're talking about five. I mean, I'm telling you, here's a chance to tell the girl, five, tens, and twenties.
Right. Bring 20s.
Hundreds, too.
Yeah, right. Yeah, we appreciate everything and we do everything with a smile. We try to have fun with it, with whatever type of girl we're dancing for. So, you know, be generous. Yeah.
What's the craziest thing a chick has done while you were doing the show? Like, you know, sometimes you guys would bring a chick out, sit her in a chair, and they're shit-faced or whatever. I mean, what's the craziest thing a girl tried to pull while you're
masturbating?
Yeah, that or
masturbating themselves or you?
Themselves.
Really?
They'll lift up their skirt or lift up their top.
That's right. We're supposed to be doing the stripping job. They're doing it.
Okay.
Chicks like get down on their knees or try to do that shit too.
Well, I said Gia a few times.
Yeah, they don't get too vulgar, but they do start taking off some clothes every once in a while.
Right.
That's for sure.
Alright, so how many chicks have you been with at one time?
This kid has all kinds of trouble. Couple?
By myself, like two.
Three?
Oh, group orgy thing, Lucky.
Well, I mean, like, actually having sex with them or just blowjobs? I mean,
well, according to Clinton, blowjob and
like Duck Duck Goose?
Yeah, no, just actually sex by myself, maybe two girls. Me and the buddy or something, maybe three or four girls or something like that. But parties, house parties, you know, like I've had like seven girls, you know.
So have you like been done with one person and then they go, oh, by the way, my friend, you know, needs it too. Does that happen?
Yeah. Like, sure.
Let's leave it up to Lucky. Lucky's saying the bare naked truth.
What's the freakiest stuff a girl's asked you to do while you're doing it with her?
Sock in the mouth?
That's a good one.
This girl, I just put a sock in her mouth. Shut the fuck up. I took my dirty snacks. It wasn't my underwear. Okay. No, it was actually, I bought up my underwear, stuffed it in her mouth, put her head in the pillow.
She enjoyed it, you said?
She loved it, bro. I think because she calls me all the time. It doesn't sound logical, but.
So, like, girls ask to be tied up or get spanked or fucked in the ass?
Tied up and spanked.
Yeah. Usually,
usually not the third.
That one Armenian girl, like, getting fucked in the ass.
Not too much crazy stuff.
This one guy was telling me a story, this hot chick. He was fucking her, and when she came, she fucking shit in the bed.
And
she knew this would happen, so she would bring like baby wipes and towels and lay it out.
You got a better story than we've done, and I do.
No shit in the bed.
So I'm trying to think of other penetrating insights we need into the world of exotic dancing. Well, shit, I can't think of anything else. You guys dance obviously in the LA and San Diego area. What clubs you guys?
LA, a lot of Riverside County, San Bernardino County. Not so much down San Diego County.
Not too much down south.
We have a couple shows. These guys do a show. I know Lucky does a show in Palm Springs. Mm-hmm. And we have a couple shows, one in Reno Valley, one Riverside, and one in City of Industry, and one in Dime Bar, too, that we do regularly.
You guys got a website?
No, not a website up now. But if you want to find out where any of the guys are dancing anytime, or you want to hire any of the guys for private parties, you can call California Hard Bodies hotline number. That's 909-225-2662.
Okay.
And you get a hold of any of these guys that way.
And if there's any ladies watching this that are web designers, I'm sure you would be more than happy to have them come and maybe develop a site for you guys. So.
If it helps out.
All right, cool. Oh, by the way, do you think they should do more of this DVD stuff you know, with guys for women? I mean, do you think that's a good thing, or you know?
I think it's a good thing. I think just like the other one we did, it's long awaited, well deserved. Mm-hmm. Hopefully they'll enjoy it.
Cool.
Hopefully you'll enjoy it.